Well, hey, friendship family, as we come to the end of yet another day in this strange season that we've been brought to in the face of the coronavirus and all the things that it has affected, I know that we can't be together right now in person, but we can be together in spirit. And so I invite you to end this day by drawing close to the Word of God with me and us walking through a passage and praying together so that we might be one in spirit even as we're distanced in person. So I invite you, take your Bible, turn to Psalm 114. It's one of the Psalms of the day, Psalm 114. And we're going to read this together, and I want to make just one point to you, and then we're going to pray together. Psalm 114. Here's what the Word of the Lord says. When Israel went out from Egypt, the house of Jacob, from a people of strange language, Judah became his sanctuary, Israel his dominion. The sea looked and fled, Jordan turned back. The mountains skipped like rams, the hills like lambs. What ails you, O sea, that you flee? O Jordan, that you turn back? O mountains, that you skip like rams? O hills, like lambs? Tremble, O earth, at the presence of the Lord, at the presence of the God of Jacob, who turns the rock into a pool of water, the flint into a spring of water. As we read this passage together, we're reminded of the story of God's people. Remember that they had been in bondage for over 400 years in Egypt, and then God, by his divine plan and through his great mercy, brought them up out of the land of Egypt. He used the hand of Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, to let his people go. He turned Pharaoh's heart this way and that in order to ultimately free his people. And then as the people of God were headed out of the land of Egypt, you remember that they came to various obstacles. They came to an obstacle at the Red Sea and God parted the sea. They came to an obstacle in the wilderness where they struggled to have water and God brought forth water from the rock. They came to an obstacle when they longed for food and for God's provision and God gave them food, manna from heaven. They came to an obstacle even as after 40 years of wilderness wandering because of their sin, they came up to the River Jordan to go into the land of promise, and God there caused the waters to recede and allowed them to walk over on dry ground. Over and over again throughout the history of Israel, God demonstrated his sovereign power over the earth in behalf of his people as he accomplished his plan for their lives. I want us to think about that because of this. Right now, our world is struck by a virus that no one really knows about. No one has control over. No one knows just exactly what's going on and how to stop it. There are all sorts of suggestions about how we can reduce its effects. There are ideas and theories about medications that will help with the treatment of its impact upon individuals. And yet, ultimately, what we realize is that in the grand scheme of things, our society and our humanity can be brought down to its knees by something as invisible as a virus. And that may cause us to panic. It might cause us to be struck with concern. We might even find ourselves wondering, how do we carry on when something so invisible, something that we can't even see, is causing such catastrophe and crisis in our world? My dear friend, I hope that this psalm would remind you of something the late great preacher Dr. Adrian Rogers used to say, that everything that is over my head is still under Jesus's feet. Brothers and sisters, there's nothing in this world that is outside of God's control. There's nothing in this world that isn't under his authority. There's nothing in this world that can thwart the plan and the will of God. In fact, everything is subject to the authority of the God who created heaven and earth and who has revealed himself to us in the person of his son, Jesus Christ. And so as you end this day, end it with the last verses of Psalm 114. Give the command, tremble, O earth, at the presence of the Lord, at the presence of the God of Jacob, who turns the rock into a pool of water, the flint into a spring of water. Let us end this day remembering that God is in control, that nothing that we face is outside of his authority, and that as we turn to him, we are turning to the one who has complete authority and complete ability to bring order, restoration, healing, and salvation to his people. Can we pray together? Father, I'm thankful for this day that you've used to remind me that everything that is over my head is under Jesus' feet. I'm thankful that on this day when we face obstacles and difficulties and diseases that are outside of our control, that Lord, they're not outside of your control, that you have perfect plans, that you have a will and a design for this world that you'll accomplish. I'm thankful, God, that this public health crisis has not taken you by surprise. You have not been caught off guard. This is perfectly known by you, and it's in your perfect control. And so, God, as we long for healing for friends and neighbors who've been impacted by this, as we seek to protect ourselves by sheltering in place and minimizing public contact, even, Lord, as we long for a day when all this has come to its end and we can get back to normal, God, I'm thankful that we can hear in the Psalms and be reminded that everything about this creation is subject to you because you are the Creator God who brought it all into being. And I'm thankful even more that not only are you the Creator who is in full control, but you are the Creator who one day will make all things new. And so, Lord, we look forward to that day when the pain and the sorrow and the difficulty of this life have passed, when you wipe away all tears from our eyes, when death and sorrow will be no more. For on that day, the entire world will come subject to your feet, and your glory will cover the earth as the waters cover the sea. Oh, we long for it, Lord, but even so, we proclaim your majesty as the one who is over all the earth. In Jesus' name we pray.